Welcome to Med Miracle. This is a very important and specific discussion to talk about a common approach for every entrance exam and highlighting the importance of appearing and how to attend the paper of PGI. We have Dr. Akhil Monga, who is ranked 12, November in 2015, and with him on his right is Dr. Ashir Kaul, who was AIIMS November rank 5, and then subsequently after a week rank 1 in November PGI 2016. Here Akhil is a senior of Ashir in the same college at All India Institute, and what Akhil has to start here is to tell us how he got a gift of studying specific and he passed on to his junior Ashir. So Akhil, you have to tell us how exactly you went about it and how you tried to decrease the load of studies by being very specific and oriented. Dr. Akhil Monga.
Hi sir, thank you so much for the introduction, and I just like to mention one thing here, that guidance in your college is something that is very important when you're starting preparing for some competition exam like AIIMS, PGI, any whichever exam you're targeting. For my case, I had a few very nice seniors who guided me towards specific things that I must read and how to save time during my internship and what topics to focus, because medicine in general is very vast. 19 subjects which are separate, like people will spend 3 years or maybe 6 years in become a master of those subjects. So trying to study that in 1 year is very difficult, and being a master of all of this is very difficult. So what we need to understand here is that a very little is required, but the basic concepts have to be very well known to each of us so that we can clear the exam. It's just the basic concepts that we can apply, and being smart at what is the things that are expected of us as interns. Basically those are us. So if somebody can guide you towards what are those things, it helps and goes a long way in your preparation. And I'm very thankful to seniors like Dr. Ravi Sharma and Dr. Zainab Bora, who were there for me at this time, and it really helped me. From the beginning, I was focused at what to study and how to study.
So now I believe, Ashir, you have to tell how the baton was passed to you and how actually you improvised on it, got better ranks, did fantastic in PGI Chandigarh. How did you go about in your internship? Just a short review we want to hear about. Dr. Ashir Kaul.
I would like to thank the team of Med Miracle for inviting me here today and giving me an opportunity to speak. Indeed, I received a lot of inspiration, motivation and guidance from my seniors while I was preparing for my PGI entrance exam. When you first enter your internship, you're really scared and apprehensive so as to how to prepare 19 subjects for an exam that is going to decide the course of your life. So at this point, when you have a senior who can guide you and tell you, who has been through all of this, I think that's a miracle in itself, which happened to me. So when you start your internship, if you're preparing for any exam, be it NEET, PGI or AIIMS, the basic concept is reading a subject or reading a topic once won't help you until and unless you revise it, because you'll not be able to retain it at the day of the exam. So unless and until you're trying to, you're able to revise a topic at least twice, it's good if you do it thrice. I think that's what's going to work for you. So when you have a plan of action in your mind on 1st of January, if you start your internship in January, you should make a study schedule in a way that you complete 3 revisions at least before your exam. So let's say if you have an exam in November, be it PGI or AIIMS, make a schedule in a way that you complete your first revision at least by the month of end of July. It doesn't matter that you have to go through all the topics in your first revision, but make sure that at least 85 to 90% of the chunk of your syllabus has been revised or gone through by you at least once till July end or early August. Then maybe another 2 or 2.5 months for your first revision, and then the most crucial part is your final revision, which will, you have to do it in the last 25 days to 1 month. That is a brief summary and a brief sum of all the important topics. Now, to do this last revision, what is important, you should know what to revise and what to omit in the last, you know. So for that, you have to, you know, go to your seniors or the team of med medical or whoever is guiding you, so that you know that what topics are important. Ab har subject ke andar you'll have topics that you feel are important that you were asked in your UG days, but then from the point of your entrance examinations, though it might not be. For example, if you consider the paper of PGI, the important subjects that you should target are, which will form the chunk of your questions, are medicine, surgery, pediatrics, obs gyne, and subjects like orthopedics, ENT, ophthal. So whenever you're going with an aim to prepare for an exam like PGI, make sure that you're thorough with at least these three subjects, so that in the least amount of time you're able to tackle the maximum number of questions, because these subjects will form at least 180 to 190 questions of your PGI paper.
Thing that is mentioned here in the beginning was that the time is constant. So even if you have 9 months, that is same for everybody. Say even if you start your internship late, you'll have the time will be fixed, and what you have to fix is three revisions. So how much you read, the content, you have to shorten that up. Nobody can read everything. Somebody may have a difficult time in their internship, somebody may not have enough time, but you have to fix your schedule such that you finish it like three times before you go to the exam. So that is something that is constant. And it doesn't matter if you read like 90% of the subjects, but if you read smart and even 60%, 70% you're able to do, but all those subjects have to be covered and have to be revised at least three times. So at least that 70% you know. And I don't think in any exam you need more than 70-80% correct. So even like that, if you know that 70-80% very well, it's more important to do it thrice than trying to go for 100% and just doing it once.
Fantastic. Asher, how did you prepare between AIIMS and PGI? What specific strategy did you do in the last 6 days? How many papers of PGI did you prepare?
I had only 1 week to prepare for PGI after my AIIMS exams, so I could only do two papers, and those papers were not just to know what questions are being asked or what subjects are important. Those papers that I did was to know the pattern of, you know, the paper of PGI and how to go about attempting the paper, because obviously it's not possible in 1 week to find out all the important subjects and read all the important points. My main aim behind attempting PGI papers before the PGI exam was to know the pattern. I used to time myself and see whether I can actually attempt 1250 options in 3.5 hours. And obviously,
did preparation, you attempt the whole paper? Time myself means, did you practically sat down and marked on a mock sheet that can I complete the paper?
Grossly, I could do that paper in about 3 hours and 45 minutes. I could only time myself for one paper. The other paper, I just went through casually. I did not time myself. But I got a rough idea that, okay, I need to pick up speed, and another day of the exam, I need to be fast. So that, you know, it gives you an idea about your position. If you're taking 4.5 to 5 hours to mark, to complete that 3.5 hours paper, then you need to work on your timing. If you're able to do it in about 3, 3.5 or 3/4 to 4 hours, I think that's okay. Rest will be seen on the day of the paper.
Okay, normally we say, why do we do previous year papers? For three reasons. Number one reason, what we said, time. Number two is to know the high yield topics. Number three is to mark the repeats correct.
I think so.
That's the usual teaching, right?
The best.
What is your take on this statement?
So the best way is, I think for the repeats, it's also a good idea to go through them even before you start your preparation. So that is one time I think going through the questions is important. Even before this week, like when you start in January, if you can go through the questions, just don't read the explanations, just go through the questions, that will give you an idea of what the topics are. Again, when you come back at this time, then you read the, like at least I think I will go for around 3 years, so it will be 6 exams. You attempt 2 for your practice, and the rest of the 2 years, you just see the questions, because if there is a repeat and you are able to get that correct, that's an added advantage. And how much time does it take to go through an exam? Not ask, you know, don't go to the explanations, just the question. I think 250 questions that you read and you have to see the answers, it won't take you like more than 3, 3.5 hours. So in a day, if you can see three papers, like I said, just sit down and look at 3 to 4 papers. And if it gives you an advantage, because I think PGI has a lot of repeats, so many options are there. If not the whole question, you will have some options, you know, that are repeated. So that's a big boon. I think you must see them once before going to the exam.
Also, I believe that you people were doing subject wise guides. Most of the guides do have PGI questions. So it is not that those questions are unseen. You have a fair idea about those questions. Anything specific that you read for PGI apart from AIIMS, Asher?
Well, I did not read any specific book or a specific guide for PGI examination. My basic preparation was for PG entrance examination. No,
it was constant.
It was constant. There was no, I'll read book A for Obs Gyne for AIIMS and I'll read book B for Obs Gyne for PGI because that is good for PGI. No, that was not my idea. I had one book for each subject and that's what I want to emphasize. We're talking about doing three revisions. How is that possible? That is possible only when you have one source of knowledge and you keep revising it. Because if you start your preparation in January and you read book A for pathology, then you start your second revision, you read some of your notes that you made somewhere in MBBS. Then you come to the third revision, you read some notes ki jo aapne kahin kisi class mein banaye the. That should not be done. If at the beginning of your preparation, you should fix, okay, I'm going to read this subject from this book, and that's where guidance from your senior comes. You should fix your book and make sure that when you revise it the next time, you read it from the same book, because that helps to improve your speed of revision. If you read from a different book every time, aapko fir se 2 ghante 3 ghante lagenge in a topic which you could have revised in 5 minutes.
So do you mark the topic that you read for the first book?
Yes,
I read it, you highlight the points.
Yes, exactly. When I read a book, I highlight my points, and that helps me when I come back to the book after 5 to 6 months, I'm able to read it faster.
Okay, do you recommending to a standard textbook in case we have a doubt in any guidebook?
Definitely, sir, because there is no guidebook which is 100% correct. And sometimes you've read something that will make you feel that this is something that I do not agree with. Or maybe there are some issues where you have different answers, like nothing, it's not sure short that this is the correct answer. So you go back to a Bible, you look at it, you see the answer, you make sure you will have the belief that this is the right answer. It may not be the right answer according to the examiner who's putting it up. But once you have the confidence, I think if you've seen all of them through one of the reference or textbooks, you'll fare out well. So yes, going back, it just gives you a confidence also that now I'm sure. See, if that book had written this answer and the other book has written this answer, I've seen through a good textbook and now I'm sure. So that just gives you an added advantage going into the exam. So the confidence is also very important, even if it may not be the perfect answer.
And let me just ask, yeah,
and there were students that I've seen, they keep arguing ki इस बुक में ये आंसर था, उस बुक में वो आंसर था, इस कॉन्ट्रोवर्शियल पॉइंट्स इधर ये बोला उधर वो बोला, एंड दे नेवर फाइंड एन आंसर एंड दे स्पेंड ऑल द टाइम एंड एनर्जी फाइंडिंग दैट आंसर टू दैट वन. यू शुड नॉट वरी अबाउट दैट बिकॉज दैट वन क्वेश्चन इज नॉट गोइंग टू डिसाइड योर रैंक. सो if after at least some attempts you're not able to find an answer, there is still a controversy, you find it in one reference book, this and that, I think you should stop wasting your time on that question. Go back to preparing the other topics and let that question be.
Revise. Read all 19 subjects.
Yes. Have 3 revisions. Have the same book.
If you are starting in January, try to complete by August.
First revision.
Last 25-30 days are very crucial for revising. The pattern of preparation for every exam is always the same. Prepare a mock test to understand how the paper is. Now we go on to the second point. Do you want to add something, Akhil?
I think that would be like basics of preparation. You should not deviate from that.
Right.
Having a study group maybe is also a very good idea. If you have 2-3 people, because these things, if 2 or 3 people are looking at such questions, somebody gets an answer, just decreases your time of that you'll apply to each question. So that just helps. Maybe you're not studying all the time together, but in general, you talk about it, what you're going around with and what you're studying right now, how much you completed. So that gives you an idea that yes, now I have to stop and I have to finish this subject and now I have to move on to the other, and you're not stuck at one place. Because when you're alone, you feel like I want to complete 100%. If you have somebody, he'll tell you, we should now next go to the next subject that we had planned. So that is one thing that is advantageous if you have a small study group.
I will just share, Ashir. When I attempted PGI, I myself qualified, I was 91. But my preparation in the last week before the exam was, go through the tables of Harrison, go through genetics and biochem. These are 2 things which you should prepare. I would like to hear from both of you the importance of those tables in Harrison. There were 230-240 tables with the same you should always read. Most of the PGI guides, they highlight the importance of these tables. Ashir, did you actually revise them in last 6 days, or you did that for AIIMS and they are same?
Well, those set of few tables that you're talking about, I revised them when I was preparing for my AIIMS exam. I did not specifically read those tables in that 1 week between AIIMS and PGI. Yes, going through those tables is important because that is like the crux of the entire medicine syllabus. And PGI, you know, likes to quote lines and facts from standard textbooks like Bailey and Love, like Harrison's, like some book for Obsgani, whichever it is. But for surgery and medicine, I think they quote a lot of Harrison. So going through those tables is important, but I would not say you leave revising those tables for PGI in that 1 week between AIIMS and PGI. Start going through those tables from the beginning, because anyway, it is going to help you in AIIMS as well. It's going to help you in NEET. It's going to help you in PGI. So keep that in mind. You should do that from the beginning and not leave it to the end, because revising 230 tables in 1 week is difficult. If you have not revised it before, if you have done it before, I think it's going to be an easy job.
Do you have some method how to revise them?
Those tables?
Yeah. Because it's very difficult to turn pages from a 3000 page book. So how did you assemble them, Akhil or Ashir?
Best thing is you find something important. I used to click it and keep it in my phone. So there are small collection that's always there for this such time when you feel I have very little time and I need to do something that is going to give me high yield. It may be, you know, you're sitting in the internship or the last 7 days before an exam. So those things will always help you at the end. When you're helpless, everybody goes through that phase 2 days before the exam, you feel there is everything to do in this world and I don't have time. So at that time, these things will help. Only thing you have to do with the smartphones today is just to click a photograph, keep it with you, make a folder, and just go through them. So that is the best way. I think turning pages is now like difficult for you to do when you don't have enough time.
So Akhil, you transfer this folder to Ashir, or Ashir made his own folder? Because what I want to say is you still have that folder. Will you give it to the next generation or they should search themselves and click it? That's what I want to ask Ashir.
I got that folder from my seniors.
Right.
I got that list of important tables.
Right.
But it is always good to have your own list of important topics.
Right.
Because nothing is absolute.
Right.
Nothing is absolute. We do not know whether that person who read it.
So you followed, but you applied your brain.
Yeah, you have to apply your brain. You have to have your, you not blindly follow anybody. But guidance is important. You know that these tables are important. But among these tables, you should know that what is important for you. You might be knowing some things very good by heart. You don't need to click those pictures, you don't need to keep revising those. You know that you're confident with this topic, you should keep it aside. But there are topics that you will be doubtful, you will not have confidence over those topics. Unki photo leke, you should keep those handy so that that becomes kind of a folder for you, custom made for you.
Right.
That
so
is
you
important.
Customize it, and you also mean to say in that particular table that you're reading, there will be different areas highlighted for every individual.
Yes.
So you are highlighting the tables as well.
Highlighting those tables, yeah, my own highlighting.
So we summarize this how to prepare.